Dr. Watson and Crick came up with their hypothesis regarding the structure of DNA, the scientific world was now curious to know how it could be replicated. They put forth a hypothesis that the DNA replicates in a semi-conservative manner. That is, both strands separate and each serves as a template for the synthesis of new strands. Template in literal terms means a pattern used as a sample to make something. However, the scientific world was not ready to accept this fact easily. So, there were three theories put forth which hinted at the replication process of the DNA double helix. One was called the conservative model, the other was the dispersive model, and the last was the semi-conservative model. Let's first understand what each method had to say. The first model in the list is the conservative model. This model suggested that two DNA strands separate and serve as templates for replication. But soon after replication, the strands join back to form the original parent DNA, while the new synthesized strands join to form a completely new DNA. Thus, we get a newly synthesized DNA molecule, and we also get the original parent DNA molecule back, which is conserved. Hence the name conservative replication. Now comes the next one. This was called the dispersive model of replication. As the name suggests, dispersive means to disperse or scatter. So what gets dispersed? Well, according to this model, the DNA which is about to replicate breaks into small fragments. The new strands get synthesized in between. As a result, we get a hybrid of both new and old strands together. The old parental strands appear to be dispersed in the newly synthesized one. Hence, this method is named as dispersive. Now comes the last model. It was called the semi-conservative model of replication. The model suggested that two strands of DNA unwind and serve as templates for newer strands. As a result, the replicated DNAs contain one old and one new strand. Hence the name semi-conservative. Nevertheless, this model was not accepted initially when put forth by Watson and Crick. However, one of the most amazing experiments in biology, named the Meselson and Stahl experiment, helped crack this mystery. Two geneticists, Matthew Meselson and Franklin Stahl, carried out an experiment around 1958. They used a heavy isotope of nitrogen and inserted it in the DNA of the bacterium Escherichia coli. They obtained several generations of E. coli and analyzed each for the presence of DNA. The results helped them understand that the replication of DNA in E. coli is indeed semi-conservative. This is how DNA replication takes place in almost all organisms. Now let me introduce you to one more interesting term. It's called the central dogma. Ever heard of this? Well, it's an important term and an equally interesting concept in biology. The central dogma in molecular biology is used to explain the flow of genetic information. And what does that mean? We all know that DNA governs life. But any idea how this mechanism works? Let's understand this with the help of the central dogma. In a cell, the DNA from the nucleus replicates to make a copy of itself. This is that we're aware of. And do we know what the functional segment of DNA is? It's a gene. It's the segment of DNA that codes for a particular character. The part of DNA which acts as a gene gets copied in the form of a single strand. This is called mRNA. This mRNA, that is the messenger RNA to be precise, is a single-strand copy of the DNA. It comes out of the nucleus in the cytoplasm and then is worked upon by the special machinery of enzymes. The enzyme machinery reads the code hidden in the mRNA and synthesizes proteins accordingly. This complete process of mRNA synthesis from the DNA, followed by the synthesis of proteins from the mRNA, is called as central dogma. In other words, the simplest process by which proteins are synthesized from the code of the DNA molecule is the central dogma of life. This is how it's usually summarized. Did you know that these two steps have a scientific name? The process in which the mRNA is synthesized from the DNA strand is called transcription. And the process in which proteins are synthesized from the code of mRNA is called translation. Would you want to know more about these interesting processes? For that, tune in to our upcoming videos.